what these people say, and they are highly incapable. They are just incapable and totally incompetent. I mean, imagine what is happening in the US and then what happened in Europe. All these leftist head of state, what they did with their governments, what they did with their countries and so on. It is pretty much hideous in that sense. And annoying. However, I never thought that I would ever bring about change. And like I said, my head goes probably beyond this. So I care little what happened in Austria. You are not going to change it. And I said it over and over again. I mean, it does not. I will not be able to change everything in Austria because, firstly, I'm a foreigner. I am perceived as a foreigner, as a second-class citizen. So if I say something that, that is not right in Austria, people immediately assume, yeah, I say this because I'm a foreigner. I say this because I feel this is some sort of a migrant identity. This is what everyone always assumes. Yeah, this migrant identity, they always have to be opposed to mainstream and so on. Well, there you have it. I mean, there you have it. You cannot bring about the change. This is the change in this society have to be brought about by the Austrians, by their own people and so on. And this does not look like it. I mean, if you have some people in the left who say, yeah, whatever it is, it is excusable as long as we prevent far right, or as long as we prevent the conservatives or far right groups to succeed. No, it is a way. No, this is not true, because it does matter how you conduct yourself. It does matter what a human being you are, and it does matter how you treat other people. Only watch in the US, how many people have to resign because they did not even half of it. Huh? And here in Austria, I mean, everything is a joke, and these people are openly mocking you. However, I mean, this podcast probably will not do not make about change. It was never the purpose. So I think in Austria and elsewhere, you have to watch for your own future, watch out for your own self. This is probably the best thing you can do. Protect yourself. And again, I mean, we live in the European Union. This is probably the only thing that's good about Austria, is that you have a European passport. This means I don't have to live in this country, and I wanted to leave for Austria a couple of weeks ago because of the vaccine mandate. I mean, they are pretty much tightening the rules. It looks like that without being vaccinated, you won't be even admitted to an airplane. Probably won't even be admitted to whatever it is, enter or whatever. So I thought about this. I mean, I don't know whether I need to be vaccinated. I mean, I don't know. Is this like getting my own blood or whatever? I don't care. I don't know. However, I mean, it was indeed, I understood that it is a possibility that you probably won't be able to leave. Leave Turkey if this goes on. So we don't know it yet, but it looks like so that there will be a vaccine mandate almost everywhere. Well, I don't leave much my home, so I don't care whether you can whether you eat in restaurants or not. Well, I don't eat in a restaurant. I don't have right now. I don't have the money to eat in a restaurant. However, but for a couple of weeks I tried to leave, and of course every time when it comes to go back to Austria, I mean, I always say it's go back, but it is not my home. It is nothing. It is just a place where you some sort of have to go, and every time this idea came up. Yeah, well, you probably have to go back and get this stupid vaccine shot, or else you are pretty much, or else things will get pretty much difficult every time. Of course, you feel some sort of a restraint from inside, because I mean, this is not my home. I mean, I don't want to go there. I don't want to live in Austria. And this is something I really felt. I mean, in the end, it didn't work out again. It is very difficult to get a home. And in addition to it, I mean, in Austria, when you land on the airport, you never know what's happening next. I mean, it is a crooked state. It is a failed state. The people dress up as policemen, as lawyers, judges, and you never know what's going on. So it is hideous and despicable. And well, you can't change it. And I don't want to live in Austria. I never wanted to. But else it did just not work out. Anything else? I mean, I'm still struggling. So it doesn't look that way that I will some sort of accomplish my goal, my great goal, to go into the U.S. to live in the U.S. This is something I really tried for a couple at time, but this again did not work out, because you still need some sort of money. This is not as easy as it was back in the days. They don't admit anyone, so you can't just jump in a plane. And yeah, you can do it in a way as a tourist, but you still need some money to stay there and so on. And right now, I mean, I don't have any. So those people who think I would be well off or something, well, I don't know anything about that. So it is indeed dire. But dire in that sense, somehow you always think, yeah, well, in a way this happens for a reason, and maybe you should some sort of change your mindset, because in a way you always think about yourself, or I always think about my own future, my own forthcoming, not realizing, well, probably this is all already already gone. This is all already will come to an end, and maybe some sort of the last stance you have is some sort, in a way, do something good for humanity, and so on. Maybe it takes a while to change your mindset. I've been thinking about this for a while. I've been thinking about my future, or about the future of others, about the future of the next generation, and what it means to leave a world behind them, to leave a world behind for them. What it would mean if they would have to go through the same struggle, if they would have to experience the same hideous experiences I had. So what it would mean, and yeah, well, this is something I started more and more to realize that this is not about me anymore. I mean, this is you have here in Turkey a lot of time to think about these things. Important. These things are bothering me. I mean, there's still you see here some Austrians sneaking around, some of these despicable people. Somehow, I don't know how they get in. We are in the pandemic. I mean, oh Jesus, it is October, so there is no beach, no whatever. This is the pandemic. This is COVID lockdown. Okay, it is not a lockdown here in Ordu in Turkey, but yet you still see these scumbags on the streets, and you're like, yo, what the hell are you doing here? And so on. I mean, this is really it is questionable. Yeah, it is. You really have to ask yourself, and yeah, I think you really need to have a lot of patience to bear this, to look at this. I mean, this depraved culture and these depraved people, what they all did and with what they all got away with. I mean, this is, I think, indeed very hideous. I mean, what they did with Jews and all these people, all these poor people, poor souls, and so on. Well, this is what it is. I mean, this is the people we have to deal with, if we have to live with. But you have to ask yourself, yeah, for how long. However, I mean, again, it's not like that I could change anyone's mind, because as a foreigner, or I did not even manage to be accepted as a human being. I did not even accomplish that people treat me with respect. So all those scumbags who talk about respect, they are, were not ready to treat me with respect. So I could not even accomplish that task. So I don't think that I will ever accomplish to change the mindset of Austrians. Maybe I don't want to. Maybe I don't care. Maybe I just give a fuck. Whatever it is, whatever it is annoying. Whatever it is, I think that, future will show. I mean, you never know. No one could have expected what would have happened here. No one did expect what has happened, and so on. So future will tell. So you only see results after a couple of years. You only see results. Maybe after a generation, we never know. Maybe after a generation, we will will have accomplished that in Austria. People are more sensible for these kinds of things. People are more sensible for racism. And maybe in the next generation will grow up with a media landscape which reports about racist incident, which does not help politics to cover up their tracks and so on. Maybe Austria will accomplish the task to arrive in the 21st century. We don't know it. However, I mean, what you of course want to have is that you want to have your peace abroad. I mean, I left this hideous country and I'm just still trying to leave it so that I have my peace abroad and don't have to deal with certain individuals. Apparently, you have to something else to get your peace. Whatever it is, a lot of things on my mind, a lot of things that just annoying, just hideous, and so on. But well, it's not, future will tell. I mean, I can't tell. I mean, like I said, when I came in January back to Turkey, I expected something else would happen. Right now we have October, so we'll see. We'll see about that. And until then, I will keep making podcasts. I will keep writing, short stories, novellas on Wattpad. I will keep myself busy in that sense. I hope that you follow me too, that you find some things I talk about interesting. Like I said, even though I say, I mean, officially I do care about what people say. I'm not like everything. Officially, I do care who watches. So yes, if you enjoy my podcast, do so in the future as well. However, this was again another episode. I'm here in Ordu, in Turkey. It is a rainy October day, so. And we are in the pandemic, so those good souls out there, take care of yourselves. So there are always, there is never enough good people on this world, and we need every good soul we can get to make this world a better place. So bye. Ciao.